do the activity of separation of mud from muddy water. For this we require a beaker containing muddy water, two empty beakers, funnel, wash bottle, a tripod stand, filter paper and a glass rod. First of all, we'll take the beaker containing muddy water, leave it undisturbed for some time. After keeping the beaker undisturbed for some time, we see that mud settles down at the bottom of the beaker. This process is called sedimentation. Now, we pour the liquid contained in the beaker into the empty beaker. This pouring of liquid into an empty beaker is called decantation. The water in the first beaker, is this water clear? No. To further clear it, we'll use a filter paper, take a funnel, place it on the tripod stand. We'll fold the filter paper in the form of a semicircle. Once again, we'll fold it in the shape of a cone. And then place it on the funnel. With the help of the wash bottle, we have to wet the filter paper so that filter paper it sticks on the funnel. Take a empty beaker and pour the water which was contained in the first beaker into the funnel. What do you observe? That the clear water is coming in the beaker as filtrate and the mud remains on the filter paper as residue. In this way, we can separate mud from muddy water by following three steps: sedimentation, decantation and filtration. Activity, we'll find out the amount of given substance that can be dissolved in a known volume of water. For this, we require water, spatula, empty beaker, a glass rod stirrer, and the substance which we have taken here is common salt. First, we'll take a known volume of water in the empty beaker. Take a spatula of common salt and try to dissolve it in water. What do you observe? We'll see that salt, it completely disappears and forms a clear solution. In this way, go on adding more spatulas of salt with constant stirring till the salt completely disappears. Again, you can see that it has formed a clear solution and we can no longer see the salt. Add more of common salt. And stir it. Now you can see that some of the salt, it remains at the bottom of the beaker and it no longer dissolves in water. It means that in this known volume of water, it contains the maximum amount of salt. Such type of solution which contains the maximum amount of the solute in the given amount of solvent, they are known as saturated solutions. In the following activity, we will see how we can separate salt from salt solution, although we know that salt is soluble in water. For this, we require a tripod stand, a kerosene burner, a glass rod stirrer, a beaker containing water, common salt, and a spatula. First of all, we will prepare a saturated solution of salt in water with constant stirring. Till it forms a clear solution. Once the entire amount of salt has completely disappeared, we'll keep this beaker containing salt solution on the kerosene burner for heating. We will see that water, it starts boiling and starts evaporating. Once all the water has evaporated, it leaves behind the solid salt as residue. This process in which water completely evaporates, leaving behind the solid salt as residue, is known as evaporation.